Hello everyone. As we seen in last lecture that we have been stuck over this session or over this slide, that is third road development plan. In this plan, we saw a one flow chart which shows us how the roads are distributed under this plan. Like there are basically three categorization: primary, secondary and tertiary. Under primary, expressways are considered and national highways are considered. In secondary, state highway and major district roads are considered. In tertiary, other district roads and village roads are considered. So we will go forward and study in detail about all these specifications, all their meaning, standards, etc. But before that, we will see for what purpose this plan was get modified. In this plan, road length up to 2001 will get constructed with road density 82 km per 100 square meter, right? Second, all weather roads will be available within 3 km for plain and 5 km for hilly area. In this, appropriate technology implemented with the use of locally available material. As compared to Nagpur Roads plan, there are few modifications like road density and secondary availability of the roads according to the terrain. Terrain means there are two type of terrain: plain terrain and hilly terrain. So they on the basis of availability of the terrain, the formation condition of road get varied. For example, in a normal terrain, in a regular terrain, terrain is nothing but the ground condition, where it is a flat ground or uneven ground, or that ground is not available, only hilly area is available. So in normal terrain, it is a very easy to construct any type of road, any type of highway. But when there is an hilly area, it gets little bit congested or it little bit difficult. So in this plan, that point was considered and make form the availability of the roads within 3 km for plain terrain, that is your normal ground, and 5 km for hilly area. So they have been started, and construction of the roads in hilly areas also with more importance. Also, they have been implemented use of locally available material. So here we will see the summary that how the roads are classified in India. First of all, they are classified on general basis, and here they are classified, and further they are classified as an Nagpur Road Development Plan for the duration 1943 to 63, Bombay Road Development Plan for the duration 1961 to 81. All these plans are planned and executed for further 20 years. Third or Lucknow Road Development Plan from 1981 to 2001, and again up to 2020, this third road development plan was again modified for further 20 years. So right now we are following this classification of the road all over the India. Wherever you have to construct the road, wherever you have to construct the highway. So up to this, it is clear. Moving towards we will see a detailed classification in Nagpur Road Development Plan. As Nagpur Road Development Plan is classified as national highway, state highway, major district road, other district road and village road. In bracket, you can see the short form that was mentioned for this highway. The short form you can also saw on the nameplate or on a stone that is provided along the length of the highway that indicates the type of highway, right? Next one. National highway. What are national highways? The main highways running through length and breadth of the India, joining major parts, capital of states, large industrial and tourist centers, foreign highways, and including roads required for strategic movements for the defense of India. Major parts like if there is like army bases or any large scale production center. It also connects capital of states, right, like Mumbai, Pune, etc., large industrial areas and tourist centers, foreign highways. It also includes strategic movements, which is planned for the defense of India, is called as national highway. In the examination, if there is a question, define national highway, you need to write all these three points. Whatever the bolded words are there, these are most important words. At the time of the PPT, I will request you to note down all these points, or after end of the lecture session, you should write all the description given in each slide individually. For example, National Highway Amritsar Ambala to Delhi Road. This is our National Highway number 1. Delhi, Agra, Kanpur, Calcutta Road, that is our National Highway 2. Around Aurangabad, National Highway 211 goes. Road width varies from 7 to 15 meters. Next one is State Highway. The highways linking up with national highways of adjacent states, districts, and headquarters, and also important cities with the states are known as state highways. Road width varies from 7 to 10 meters. Major district road, MDR. The important roads within a district serving areas of production and markets and connecting these places with each other or with main highway are known as major district roads. In this, serving areas of production and markets means whoever is an agricultural person get his cultivated product to sell to the needy people at some place, right? So that place is called as market, and production is nothing but any industry or any field which is of particular crops. For example, farmers get their output to the market and they sold over there, and from that market all over city that product is get distributed. So for connecting these two places, production place and the market place, the connecting road is known as major district road. It having road width 7 meters. Other district roads, ODR, the roads serving rural areas of productions and providing them with outlet to the market centers, tehsil headquarters, railway stations, etc., are known as other district roads. Again, it is forming serving rural areas, production, right? If there is a farm which is far away from any city, so it gives connectivity to that production farm and providing them outlet to the market. Again, it connects tehsil headquarters, railway station, etc. Village roads. The roads connecting villages or groups of village with each other or with the nearest road of higher category or any developed area are known as village roads. As we see, what is village roads? So here we will do a quick review that classification of roads in India according to Nagpur Road Plan. It is classified as National Highway, State Highway, Major District Road, Other District Road, and विलेज रोड एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू थर्ड रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज लखनऊ डेवलपमेंट प्लान प्राइमरी सिस्टम सेकेंडरी सिस्टम एंड टर्शरी सिस्टम एंड दिस वी ऑलरेडी हैव बीन स्टडीड इन डिटेल एक्सप्रेसवे नेशनल हाईवे अंडर प्राइमरी सिस्टम स्टेट हाईवे MDR अंडर सेकेंडरी सिस्टम एंड ODR VR अंडर टर्शरी सिस्टम सो फ्रॉम नाउ यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द शॉर्ट फॉर्म विद द फुल नेम लाइक एक्सप्रेसवे इज अ फुल नेम बट NH इज फॉर नेशनल हाईवे SH इज फॉर स्टेट हाईवे MDR इज फॉर मेजर डिस्ट्रिक्ट रोड ODR इज फॉर अदर डिस्ट्रिक्ट रोड VR इज फॉर विलेज रोड्स नेक्स्ट वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ अर्बन रोड्स सो अप टू दिस वी हैव बीन स्टडीड जनरल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रोड्स क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रोड्स अकॉर्डिंग टू नागपुर रोड प्लान क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रोड्स अकॉर्डिंग टू थर्ड रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान नाउ दिस ऑल थ्री क्लासिफिकेशन आर फॉलोड ऑल ओवर द इंडिया बट वॉट अबाउट पर्टिकुलर सिटी हाउ द रोड्स टू बी गेट डेवलप्ड और गेट प्लान इन अ पर्टिकुलर सिटी टू कनेक्ट ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द सिटी विथ ईच अदर एंड to nearer available undeveloped or remote area. So for that purpose, there is classification of urban roads. Urban is meaning a city, any developed area. Urban road means roads in city or developed area. So in urban area, the roads are classified as arterial roads, subarterial roads, collector streets and local streets. Okay, so all these four are available or can be planned, has to perform in a developed city. So we will see in detail one by one. 1.5.1 arterial road. In the image you can see there is a road permit. Okay, imagine there is a divider at the central part and the vehicles are moving in opposite direction to each other. What are arterial roads? Streets primarily for thorough traffic on continuous route but with high level of traffic mobility are known as arterial roads. Thorough traffic means huge traffic. Continuous route, the road is having a maximum length more than 10-15 kilometers. With high level of traffic mobility. Mobility means continuous movement of the vehicles on that road pavement. No, on this road surface, no frontage access is allowed. Frontage access is means space provided for resting purpose or for standing vehicles. Very little crossings are provided on such type of roads. Little crossing means only few crossings means like two or three number of crossings are provided. I would like to give a best example of such type of road is our Jalna road. On Jalna road, there are thorough traffic throughout the day or specifically during the peak period of time like in morning hours, in evening hours. It's having a continuous route and a high level of traffic mobility means continuous movement of the vehicle. It is having a very little cross traffic. On this, design speed is allowed 80 km/h. Pedestrian allowed to walk only at the intersection. As we can see, the design speed means allowable speed limit of the vehicle is very high. So there is a chances of accident. For that purpose, pedestrians are allowed to walk only at the intersection. Points and the example is Jalna road. Okay, so your longest route arterial road in Aurangabad is Jalna road. Second, 1.5.2 subarterial roads. In image, if you consider this as an arterial road, then this secondary will be subarterial road. Now, what is the difference as compared to that within it? Street primarily for thorough traffic on a continuous route. It is same having a thorough traffic and a continuous route in a length, but having lower level of traffic mobility than arterial roads. It's having less mobility than arterial, means the movement of the vehicle is quite lesser as compared to arterial roads. Design speed allowed is 60 km/h. Land width is provided 30 to 40 meter. In this land width, we consider this as in carriageway or width of the roadway. Further to that, a shoulder portion is provided for walkway, for drainage line, and few space is provided for future development. So the total length is provided is known as land width. Available length for the road is known as land width. Example is road from Dargah to Amarpeet signal. Right, as we consider this as an Jalna road, so come to an Amarpeet signal chalk, and from that to Dargah chalk, this road is considered as subarterial road. Remember this example in Aurangabad or in your available areas, so that it will elaborate you to differentiate all the kind of roads in urban areas. Next, we will see collector streets. Right? In the image, this is your arterial road. This is your subarterial road. So, further to that, dividing road is collector streets. As the name is indicating, collector means there is some function that it collects from something and delivers to somewhere. Streets which provides access to arterial streets, and they collect and distribute traffic from and to local streets and sub-arterial roads. Means these roads collect the traffic from internal societies to each other and again transfer this volume of traffic to the sub-arterial road. Then through with the help of sub-arterial road, the traffic was transferred to arterial road. Okay. It is located most of in residential, business and industrial areas. Full access is allowed, means any kind of vehicle can move through that street. On that street, due to lesser width, parking is permitted. It should require a special increment in the width of the road for provision of parking on the road surface. Design speed allowed is, design speed, always remember, design speed is nothing but the allowable vehicle speed limit. Okay, so you have to maintain 50 km/h on such streets. Again, land width is provided 20 to 30 meter. Example, road from Chetak Ghoda to Roplekar, or from Roplekar to Chetak Ghoda. Again, we will go to the image. This is our Jalna road. That is arterial road. This one is subarterial road from Amarpeet Chowk to Dargah Chowk. This one is our collector street from Roplekar Chowk to Chetak Ghoda Chowk. Remember such examples so that it will be easier to remember. And the last one, 1.5.4, local streets. What are the local streets? The streets which provides access to abutting streets are known as local streets. Abutting streets means the streets available in that area. It may be arterial, subarterial, or any other. So, what is the purpose of this street? These streets are give the connectivity to different localities with each other and to the nearer collector, subarterial, and arterial streets. It has less volume of traffic at low speed. Design speed is 30 km/h. Lesser speed is allowable just because of the congested colonies will be there, school areas will be there, hospitals will be there. For that purpose, on the local street, vehicle speed limit is given as 30 km/h. Land width is provided 10 to 20 meters, which is showing lesser width. Example is street meets to the road from Chetak Ghoda to Roplekar from different colonies. As again come to the image, दिस वन इज अवर आर्टेरियल रोड, जालना रोड. दिस वन इज अवर सब आर्टेरियल रोड फ्रॉम अमरप्रीत चौक टू दरगाह चौक. दिस वन इज कलेक्टर स्ट्रीट फ्रॉम रोपलेकर चौक टू चेतक घोड़ा. एंड द वॉट एवर द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग स्ट्रीट्स, और यू कैन से इन अ लोकल लैंग्वेज गली, जो छोटी छोटी गलियां यहाँ से आती है और ये मेन रोड को मिलती है, इन छोटी छोटी गलियों को हम लोग बोलेंगे लोकल स्ट्रीट्स. ठीक है, सो वी विल रिव्यू ओवर हियर अगेन रोड क्लासिफिकेशन इन इंडिया. दैट इज फर्स्ट क्राइटेरिया वॉज जनरल क्लासिफिकेशन. अंडर जनरल क्लासिफिकेशन व्हाट वी हैव बीन स्टडीड, फर्स्ट वन अकॉर्डिंग टू ट्रैफिक फ्लो, अकॉर्डिंग टू रोड कैरिंग कैपेसिटी दैट इज टनेज, थर्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू इम्पोर्टेंस क्लास वन क्लास टू एंड क्लास थ्री, फोर्थ अकॉर्डिंग टू लोकेशन एंड फंक्शन, एंड लास्ट वॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू मटीरियल यूज. दैट वॉज जनरल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रोड्स. फर्दर वी हैव बीन सीन इन डिटेल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रोड्स अकॉर्डिंग टू नागपुर रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान. इन दैट वी हैव बीन सीन स्टेट हाईवे, नेशनल हाईवे, मेजर डिस्ट्रिक्ट रोड, अदर डिस्ट्रिक्ट रोड एंड विलेज रोड. एंड द लास्ट वॉज लखनऊ रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान. इन दैट प्लान ओनली वट एवर द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन गिवन इन नागपुर रोड प्लान दैट वॉज कैटेगराइज, अगेन कैटेगराइज इन टू प्राइमरी सिस्टम, सेकेंडरी सिस्टम एंड टर्शियरी सिस्टम. लास्टली वी हैव बीन सीन रोड डेवलपमेंट इन अर्बन एरिया इन अ पर्टिकुलर सिटी दैट वॉज आर्टेरियल स्ट्रीट, सब आर्टेरियल स्ट्रीट, लोकल स्ट्रीट एंड कलेक्टर स्ट्रीट. एज वी हैव टू रिमेम्बर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आर्टेरियल स्ट्रीट इज जालना रोड. सब आर्टेरियल स्ट्रीट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज रोड फ्रॉम अमरप्रीत चौक टू दरगाह चौक. लोकल स्ट्रीट विल बी कंसिडर एज द roads which are coming from different localities. Collector street will be considered as from Roplekar Chowk to Chetak Ghada Chowk, right? So here this is a revision. At the time of study you need to write all detailed classification of these things, general classification with the specific value, Nagpur road development plan with the definitions and allowable road width, Lucknow road development plan with the tabular form, and road development in urban area with the definitions and also diagrams. In the examination also you have to mention that diagram. That will improve your performance to achieve the complete marks. There will be not the deduction of marks. In the examination there will be compulsory question for 4 marks or maybe for 2 marks that give a detailed elaboration of classification of roads in urban areas or according to Nagpur road, Lucknow road or general classification. In general classification it may be happen that they will ask only give the classification of road according to tonnage or according to traffic volume flow. Okay, so these are the roads. What is the roads? Road is a nothing but finished surface. For constructing road the layer of material is being provided. So during the construction it is considered as that road is pavement, right? So further we will see what is pavement and combination of different materials in particular thickness which forms an road surface is known as pavement. There are two types of pavement, flexible pavement and rigid pavement. The flexible pavement is the earthen, gravel, water-bound macadam and bituminous roads are known as flexible pavement. Flexible, the word is indicating that there may be a changes in their dimensions. For example, in summer season we see the bituminous roads start melting and the surface bitumen starts flowing according to the slope in a little manner. That is not visible, but after some time we can see the road pavement is get little bit extended in their width. So that behavior will be flexible behavior and that can only happen in bituminous roads. earthen roads. Earthen roads means the roads which are constructed with the help of natural soil. Gravels. Gravels are nothing but the boulders. What about macadam that we have been seen? PMGSY roads made up of these materials. And the last one, rigid pavement. Rigid pavement, the word rigid means there is no availability of extension is being provided. Not in the width, not in the length, not in the surface. Whatever will be the failures available or occurs that was available on the surface and at the midpoint of the roadway. So, rigid pavement, cement concrete roads are known as your rigid pavement. So, here we will conclude our chapter number 1, that is overview to highway engineering. Again, I will review few points, like we will do quickly review of our chapter number 1 or unit 1, that is overview to highway engineering. We firstly have been studied scope and importance of roads in India, characteristics of roads, general classification according to Nagpur road plan, according to third road plan, and in urban areas, right? And last was pavement, that is flexible pavement and rigid pavement. In all the chapter or in all the contents, scope and importance is most important. There will be always a 4-mark question for in the examination and classification. Okay, so prepare chapter number 1 and ask for any query. Thank you.